10 random camera and photo tips coming up. Hi guys, my name is Matti Sulanto and I'm a photographer. I recently shared 10 random camera and photo tips, and in this video I'm going to share another 10 random camera and photo tips. And the best part is that these tips will work with every camera and for every photographer. Let's get started. Number one, always keep a spare memory card in your camera bag. It can happen to all of us that we forget to take a memory card with us when we go out and plan to take some pictures. And of course, we can't take any pictures if we don't have a memory card. I have a bunch of these older, a little bit slower memory cards that I don't usually use. But I keep one of these cards in every camera bag that I own. I have quite a few camera bags, but because these cards are not very valuable, I always keep one card, one spare card in every camera bag. And if I happen to forget to put a card in my camera, I still have this spare card and I can finish the job or finish the photo walk and even maybe capture some great photos. Number two, never pack in a hurry. If you know that you have an assignment tomorrow or you are going to take a photo walk tomorrow, always pack your gear today, tonight. So tomorrow when you take off, you just have to pick your bag or your gear and you know that everything is there. If you pack in a hurry, you are likely to forget something like a memory card or a battery or some other piece of gear that you are going to need. So never pack in a hurry, always do that in advance, and you will always have everything with you, everything that you need. Number three, always use a lens hood if possible. A lens hood will protect your front element from occasional accidental bumps or knocks, and it will also act as a shock absorber if you happen to hit your lens or camera against a wall or some other hard surface. And in some situations, a lens hood can always prevent some stray light hitting your front element, which can potentially ruin your picture. So always use a lens hood if only possible. Number four, bring a backup camera. Anything can happen with your main camera. The battery can die, or you may drop the camera and it might not work after that anymore, or anything is possible. So it's a good idea to have a backup camera. Some people are happy to have their phone as their backup camera. My backup camera is the Ricoh GR3. It's always in my camera bag or in my pocket. And sometimes it's my main camera, but if it's not my main camera, it's my backup camera, and I can always pull that out and continue shooting if something happens with my main camera. So it's never a bad idea to have a backup camera with you. Number five, how to remove a stuck filter. If you have managed to over-tighten a filter or a step-up ring onto your lens, it can be really, really super, super difficult to remove. My tip is to get a pair of rubberized work gloves. And with the rubberized gloves, you can get enough grip on the filter or the step-up ring, and it's easy to remove. And it works every time. I have used it several times and it works every time. So get a pair of rubberized work gloves and you never have to fight with the stuck filter or a step-up ring anymore. Number six, play with your camera. Learn every button, learn every dial, and learn everything in your camera. Play with your camera, play with your camera with your eyes closed, and just learn your camera through and through. And the better you know your camera, the better photographer you're going to be. The less you have to think about your camera when you are using it, the better pictures you're going to make, because all your concentration is on the photography itself and not on the camera. So play with your camera, learn how the buttons and dials work and how all the options work. and you're going to be also a better photographer. Number 7, try vintage lenses. If you are a mirrorless camera user, get a couple of cheap adapters and a couple of inexpensive film camera lenses, and I guarantee you're gonna have a blast. Those old lenses usually feel fantastic. They are made of metal, and some of them are super, super inexpensive. Some of them are not necessarily optically perfect, but they can still deliver pleasant looking pictures. So give it a try. There's nothing much to lose. They hold their value usually pretty well, but there is much to gain. I think you can get a really pleasant experience with these old lenses. So my tip is to give them a try. Number 8, try black and white. Turn on black and white JPEGs on your camera. Forget about the RAW, forget about the colors. Only see the world in black and white or grayscale. It's going to make you a better photographer because you learn to see the light and the composition in a totally different way because you don't pay any attention to the color information at all. And with the modern mirrorless camera, it's also very easy because you can see a black and white preview in the viewfinder or on the back screen. So give it a try. It's going to be a good practice and it's going to make you a better photographer. Number 9, take advantage of the custom modes on your camera. Most cameras have at least 3 custom modes where you can save your most frequently used settings. And I think it's a good idea to use these custom modes. You can save maybe your favorite video settings and your favorite photo settings at least, because usually your video settings are way different from your photo settings. And then it's really fast and easy to return to those settings whenever you need them. So use those custom memory settings on your camera and save your favorite settings on them. Number 10, read the manual. Manuals have bad reputation because they are confusing and they don't tell everything, etc., etc. But I still think it's a good idea to go through the manual because usually what you're looking for is in the manual. Whenever I get a new camera, whether it's for review purposes or whether I bought a new camera, I go through the manual because then I will usually get a very good overall view of the functions and features of the camera. And if I have a problem with the camera, I usually find the solution in the manual. So I highly recommend for you to read the manual because usually what you're looking for is there. And if you bought a used camera but you did not get the manual, you can most probably download it anyway. It's so easy these days. So my tip is to read the manual. So there you have it, another 10 random photo and camera tips. I hope you enjoyed it. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you in the next video.